Hello everybody, we will be playing Game of Thrones from Cyanide. It's not the Telltale game, it's an RPG game. It's from Cyanide, it's a fun game. I played maybe 1 hour, so we will start back.
Year 298, Westeros, realm of the Seven Kingdoms. The world has changed. The ancient Targaryen line of kings had its fire extinguished after reigning over the Seven Kingdoms for many centuries. Robert Baratheon's rebellion unified most of the realm's great houses under a single banner, thus bringing about the fall of the Targaryens. Thus, 15 years ago, he acceded to the Iron Throne, becoming Lord of the Seven Kingdoms. Far from the Game of Thrones and political intrigues, far to the north, in the land where winter seems never to die, a border cuts the continent in two, the Wall. The Night's Watch has been its guardian for thousands of years, protecting the realm at all costs from wildling attacks and other menaces from beyond. The danger is constant, the cold is bitter, and death is sweet for those who fall. At times, even the bravest warriors give up and attempt to escape this white purgatory.
Okay.
That you were the one he'd send, Mars. Damned moment. It had to be you, huh?
It's over, old brother. All your attempts are in vain. You know I'll end up taking you to Castle Black, dead or alive.
Why not let me get away for old time's sake? After all, we're brothers.
You betrayed us by attempting to escape, my friend. My duty is to bring you back. You know there's only one way to leave the Night's Watch.
I'm sorry, Mors, you leave me no choice. Oh, shit.
Okay, so, present day, 15 year. It's been 15 years since you abandoned your family and your lands to walk to the icy stone of the Wall, the sole barrier against the darkness that threatened to sweep down from the north. Your tribe has chosen to act with integrity in a world divided between those who command and those who serve. In return, you were given another choice. The same choice as all other criminal and traitor in the Seven Kingdom, death, or a life of exile in the Night's Watch. But will not death have been a far sweeter fate than a life of misery and violence? The outside world has forgotten this desolated place, lost in eternal winter. The wall slowly drains every last breath from those who patrol it, stealing the last dregs of warmth from their souls. On this bleak day, after hunting down a deserter, you are returning to the place you call now. No, you're returning to the place you now call home. The headquarters of the Night's Watch, Castle Black. Okay. So, I am Morse, a ranger in the Night's Watch, the military order charged with protecting and holding the immense wall separating the realm of the Seven Kingdoms from the Wildlands to the north. You are tormented by your past, a veteran and hero of Robert Baratheon's rebellion, which brought an end to the ancient order. Great betrayed your lord, you were forced to leave your family and homeland to move the wall, far from the warmth and love of your wife and daughter. Okay, so I betrayed my lord. That's not nice. Yeah, I'll take this one. Don't want those. Those is give yourself a strength, but if you do this, you need to give yourself some weakness. It's kind of a good system, actually. But no.
Castle Black. Nothing's changed since the day we arrived. 15 years. Remember, Morse? We were so strong back then. At the time, I really believed in the mission of the Night's Watch, you know?
You've changed, old brother. I never thought you would betray us.
Aye, well, you've always had a knack for choosing friends. One night here, and you'd already bashed in three of our brother's skulls.
I wasn't the only one there, if I remember rightly.
That's me. I never think of the consequences. All I do is give.
Look at this, boys. Morse finally brought back that worm, Gorol. Well done. Some men bet against you, but I wagered you'd make it. It must have been quite a hunt.
Gorol knows how to cover his tracks and isn't half bad with the sword.
I've known you for 15 years, but I still had just a shred of hope that I'd give you and your damn dog the slip. I would have hated getting caught by a little shit like our friend here.
Hold your tongue, deserter.
That's not what your mother said last night.
I'll teach you about respect, dog!
Enough! I forbid you to touch him. You would not have had the slightest chance against him, blade in hand. Tell me, where is Mormont?
The Lord Commander is in front of the Commander's keep with the new recruits. They've just sworn their oath.
So they are finally sworn brothers of the Night's Watch. Fools. Now you can teach them a little lesson. Right, Mors?
Mors, you've brought this traitor back. I knew I could count on you.
I did what I had to, Lord Commander.
Your modesty does you honor. Recruits, listen to me. Mors here is our best tracker. Now that you are sworn brothers of the Night's Watch, he will mold you into rangers. He has just returned from a very delicate mission, tracking down Gorolds, who took the cowardly route and deserted. In the name of the Night's Watch, I thank you, Mors. I know how hard it must have been for you to hunt down a friend.
I swore an oath to the Watch. If we go back on our word and our mission, then we are nothing.
If only all my men spoke like that.
Speaking of new brothers, I see only four of them. Where is the fifth?
Someone attacked him last night. He's been looked after by Maester Aemon as we speak. One of our brothers has broken his vows in the most sordid manner. That traitor then beat the poor boy and left him in the snow more dead than alive.
That's damn a it. Shame.
I swear I'll skin the culprit alive.
Alas, we do not know if the boy will recognize his assailant, or even if he is to survive.
Too bad. The brat certainly was a pretty boy, soft as a virgin. What a pity I never managed to corner him.
Shut your trap. What more can you do to me? I'm a dead man anyway.
Silence, traitor. Each time I pass judgment on a deserter, I feel the bitterness of failure. It is my duty, as Lord Commander of the Night's Watch, to make true brothers of you. This morning, you were strangers. Now, you have all sworn to honor our oath. Some come to us as knights, carrying out their duties, and some as criminals, forced to choose between the noose and the wall. Once you take the black, your past is dead. You must wash away your former loyalties, forget your family and friends. They cease to exist. Such is the strength of our oath. No wife, no children, no lands. All that matters is defending the wall and the realm. We are your only home. We are your duty. We are your new family, the only one that matters now. More than 8,000 years ago, humanity itself was nearly lost during the Long Night. Our predecessors then built the wall that you see behind us. This massive wall of ice is 700 feet high and divides the continent in half. It protects the realm of the Seven Kingdoms from threats beyond the wall. Defending it is our purpose, our duty. The Night's Watch has unfailingly carried out this mission for centuries, generation after generation. Wildlings, cold, wind, and dishonor. Those are your enemies, even in the midst of a summer such as this one. We have all taken our vows before the gods, whichever gods they are. If you betray your brothers,
if you break this sacred oath. Throughout the seven kingdoms of Westeros, you will be met with one punishment. Death. I believed in you. You were a sworn brother. By deserting, you betrayed me. You betrayed all of us, your brothers, as well as your duty to the Seven Kingdoms. From now on, you'll just be remembered as another head chopped off as a warning to others.
Yeah. I knew you'd never understand. I sincerely hope that you never find yourself in my position, Mors.
Gorald was a brother of the Night's Watch for almost 15 years, but that bears no relevance. He will be executed for desertion.
Yeah.
Beyond our mission, we no longer exist. Any last words, deserter?
After all my years spent here, I've forgotten what warmth is. The cold has stolen the very memory. Go ahead and smile at the sight of me, the wretched deserter. But you may do the same one day. You won't be able to take it any longer, and you'll do anything just to live again. I tried my luck, and I failed. Come on, Mors. And do it well.
Oh, yeah.
Goodbye, old brother.
Goodbye, old friend. I'll see you on the other side.
You will die in the shadow of the wall. There is no other way. Welcome to the Night's Watch. Mors, take Ronit, Poddy, Seltigar, and Patrick, and put together a patrol. Make sure they smell a little less like summer before winter comes.
Right. Listen. Since I need to teach you to survive at the wall, let's see what you're worth with a blade in your hand. Gather in the exercise yard.
I would have preferred to give you some respite, of course.
So, Seltigar, you were as excited as a virgin to see your hero behead that poor Gorold, weren't you?
Watch your tongue, peasant. Lowborn scum like you often end up the same way.
Oh, just listen to him. Still with his milk teeth and he wants to roar. Who knows, you little shit? I may even have been the one to squirt you into your mother's belly.
One more word like that, and I'll send you back to the shit heap where you were born.
Silence, Ronit. I'm here to train you. Let's see if your blade is as sharp as your tongue.
Very well. I'll show you what I learned in the back alleys of King's Landing, Sir Mors.
Sheathe your tongue and be on your guard.
Approach!
Let me see what you're made of.
At ease. Mors, you must speak. I've just returned from the infirmary with some very sad news. Maester Aemon could do nothing to save the boy. He has succumbed to his wounds. They were too grave.
These are dark times for us.
Justice must be done, Mors, for the honor of the Night's Watch. Before he died, the boy had enough strength to give us the name of his tormentor. He is one of ours, Cregan.
Oh no.
Cregan? First Gorold deserts, and now one of our best veterans betrays his vows?
You know what I expect from you, Mors. Cregan is leading the Western Patrol. They left this morning.
I will leave immediately. Shall I take the new brothers with me to track down Cregan?
They may still smell like summer, but I need them to learn how to patrol the wall. On the other hand, you'll have to do without Patrick. The builders need him.
All right, Jor. Cregan certainly is a big fellow.
I know. He's almost as good a fighter as you. Do not endanger your new brothers too much. We're too short of men to waste them. If you hurry, you should be able to catch up with him in the ruins of the Icemark Fort.
Understood.
One final thing. I received a raven bearing news that concerns you.
What?
A knight in the service of the King's Hand is riding towards Castle Black. He is coming especially to speak to you.
The Hand of the King, eh? I wonder what he wants with me.
I was actually hoping that you could enlighten me on that matter.
My life belongs to the Night's Watch, Jor. I left the Game of Thrones behind long ago.
So be it. May the gods speed you.
Listen here, you crows. We meet at the West Gate and leave within the hour.
Patrick!
that been fun. That's good. Let's ruin the common hall.
Mine alone. Want some, you'll have to ask.
And no longer tools for anyone.
Most of them seem like reliable lads.
I prefer the kids. They look all innocent, but they often adapt better.
Seems Mormont wants us to retake Icemark.
Sorry. The old bear must be dreaming. There'll never be a...
It's Mors' dog, and Mors does what he likes. You'd best keep your mouth shut around him.
What did a dog do to you?
I just don't like dogs. Especially that one.
Look how they're gorging themselves.
Mors!
What do you want of me, Walder?
I have finished restoring the statuette that you entrusted me with just before you left to track down Gorold.
Really? Let's have a look.
I must say it was a true pleasure. Brothers normally ask me to paint them a pretty woman with big teats and spread legs. But I must say that this is a little more original. I realize we aren't the best of friends, but this statue is a work of art. I hope I treated it with the attention it deserved. I'm rather proud of my work. I returned it to its original colors, and it looks like new.
It's beautiful work, Walder. I have never seen such a striking likeness of the warrior. It's as if you have given him life.
It would appear the frost has not completely eaten away my hands. I hope you don't regret the price you paid for this job.
Not at all. This statue is worth more than you can imagine.
What's
true,
that statue?
Actually, I have a vague idea of it. I've already seen this kind of work in the past, but only once. At the Great Sept of Baelor of King's Landing. I recall legends telling of statues made by the first disciples of the Seven, when they still strode the hills across the narrow sea. They were carved into a star that the Seven had torn from the heavens. These statues depicted the true face of the gods, just as they were when they showed themselves to the Andals.
And it is said
that the Andal's greatest heroes carried them off when they snatched Westeros from the First Men and the Ancient Gods.
How could a man such as yourself find himself in possession of such a precious object? I've never taken you to be such a devout man.
This statuette of the warrior has always belonged to my family, as far back as the bloodline stretches. It is because of this that he walks alongside us. Have you heard of the Battle of the Field of Fire?
Ah, now there's another great tale. At the time of Aegon the Conqueror's conquest, the Lannister King and the King of the Reach united their forces to fight the Targaryen and their dragons.
This is not just any old tale. This battle really took place, and it was the greatest massacre in the history of the Seven Kingdoms. On that day, more than 4,000 knights perished in the fire of those three great dragons. Aemory Westford, my ancestor, fought under the colors of the Lion, as is our duty. When the shadows of the dragons blotted out the sky, and their fire engulfed both men and beasts, he prayed for his life, as he had never done before. He swore then, on his immortal soul, that he would search for and gather all seven, collecting the six other statues which accompany the warrior. Aemory survived, and he set about his quest to give thanks to the seven. He never succeeded, and our bloodline inherited his oath.
I imagine that faith comes more easily when one rushes into the jaws of such monsters. It's a beautiful tale, all the same. You know, I could maybe help you keep this ancient promise, Mors.
Let's just say that I'm interested. What do you hope to gain from it?
Sometimes it's pleasing to be able to work on something just because it's beautiful, Mors. What I want is to finish what I've begun, before I'm judged by the Father.
Would you do it for free?
I've not taken so much joy in anything since I chose to take the black, and you know how important the faith is to me. If I could help you accomplish this sacred vow of your ancestors, I'd be paying homage to the gods for all their graces.
And how would you do that?
This statuette, it was created to be part of the Group of Seven.
Yes, we already spoke of it.
Wait, you don't understand. I've studied it closely, and I can tell you it was made to be bonded to other objects carved from the same strange rock. Probably a bracelet or an amulet that the Andal warriors bore, like the seven-pointed star they carved into their chests. I believe I'm capable of reconstructing such a work. More than 4,000 years after its imagining, it would be magnificent.
Walder, what are you suggesting? I do not follow.
I should be able to make copies of the statuettes that go with this one. With good models, it should be possible.
Out of the question. That would mean going back on the word of my ancestors. This is about an act of faith and the honor of my bloodline, Walder.
Forgive me. I understand what you say. I've never seen a rock that compares to this one. It's perhaps true what the legends say when they claim they were carved from a star fallen from the heavens.
That may well be. I thank you, and I would leave you now.
Wait, I can restore them, just as I brought the warrior back to life for you. These statuettes are not unique, though extremely rare. I told you I remember seeing three whole sets in the Great Sept of Baelor.
You speak of a world which is closed to us, my brother.
I'd be happy to share this dream with you. If you ever manage to lay your hands on another of these precious relics, I doubt it would be in good repair. But I can restore all their beauty for you.
I thank you, Walder. Indeed, your help would be invaluable to me.
Truly? Well, all that remains for me is to pray to the Seven that they finally bestow their kindness upon you, Mors.
We have what remains of our lives to find out.
May the warrior guide your arm, and the crone light your way.
And may the father forgive you for everything else.
You're bloody right there, brother.
Okay. I must find other statuettes.
Pray excuse me, Sir Mors. I would like to ask you a few questions, if you have the time.
Go ahead and ask.
Here at Castle Black, the brothers tell many tales about you. They speak of the legendary battles you fought before joining the Night's Watch, and about how you earned the name The Butcher, faced with the barbarians from beyond the wall.
The wildlings? Just what do you think you know about them, lad?
I heard that they're bloodthirsty barbarians who worship the White Walkers and mate their women with the Others. They sometimes try to claw their way over the wall to steal our women and destroy our land, thirsting for our blood.
And if they were here, their eyes would launch showers of lightning to make the Night's Watch tremble, and balls of fire would fly from their asses. It's shit. The wildlings are a real danger. However, they are normal men, like any other, which is exactly why they are such a threat. They attack when they're hungry, or when their balls are too full. There's nothing more dangerous than a hungry man.
To be starving and ready to do anything to survive. I've been there. That's why I ended up here.
Enough talk. Listen, Cragan is well liked by his men. He's a good leader. They may not take kindly to us going after him. Be ready for anything. If there's trouble, stay together. Keep an eye on the brother fighting by your side, and all should be fine.
By the Seven! I hope that it won't come to us fighting our own brothers.
What? You're not from a fighting family, Pod? Oh, it feels just like home to me.
Right. Quiet now. We have a mission to accomplish. The Lord Commander is counting on us.
Yeah.
Is there nothing left alive along the... wall?
I'm so cold!
So close to Castle Black. And Cragan's patrol should be here already. We need to find out more.
But there are only four of us. Could there be more of them?
Four brave sworn brothers of the Night's Watch.
You wanted action, right? Well, this is it. So stop.
Thank you. Cragan, what happened here?
The butcher's here? You're too late. There are wildlings everywhere. I killed a few, but there are too many. Two of them. Mors. They're beasts, I tell you. I did what I could do to save my lads by luring some of the bastards to me.
Why did your men go?
I sent them to try their luck crossing the bridge. Get out of here. If you want to live, Mors, go.
You piece of trash. A raper like you doesn't deserve to die this well.
The scavengers will take care of him.
And those of all the wildlings he killed. Not bad at all.
When your time comes, do as he did, and take as many with you as you can.
We'll try to remember that, sir.
We must leave, Sir Mors. We don't have a chance.
Remember what happened to Gorold, Poddy.
If I must die, at least I'll plant my dagger in my killer's eye.
I hope that it will be so, Ronit. Cragan was carrying the keys to the fort. They're probably still on his body.
Thank you.
out! That one's still moving! The bastard got rotted! I'll finish him off!
He's mine. Don't touch a thing without my permission.
I didn't want to deprive you of that honor, sir.
You're as dangerous as ever, Butcher. At least I buried one of your boys.
Dogs like you always travel in packs. Your leader must be nearby. Where is he? Where is Gorn?
Shit on you, Crow!
If you have any beliefs at all, you should start praying. You'll be a wolf's meal before the night's over.
You don't even have the balls to finish your dirty work, Crow! Your pity is insulting! I will be avenged! The Half-Hand won't get here in time to save you! My brothers are coming for you, Butcher! Gorn will have your hide! As soon as we've ripped open your wall, he'll tear your heart from your chest and devour it, as promised.
Damn, that's
so
harsh.
So he really is here with the rest of your tribe. Thank you.
May the White Walkers take you.
May the demons of the Seven Hells give him what he deserves.
Save your hatred for the living. We have many more to kill.
What are your orders, brother?
There's a whole clan of wildlings not far from here, and they know that we've spotted them. He mentioned Halfhand. Corrin Halfhand is relentless. If he's tracking these wildlings, he'll get them. If I know Gorn, he's surveying the area and preparing an ambush to slow down the Brothers of the Shadow Tower. We'll go down and keep them from getting the passage back open. They'll be stuck here, and our brothers can just finish them off.
Perfect. The dogs will be trapped.
And us with them!
It's a risk we have to take. We can't let this opportunity go. Gorn is one of the most dangerous leaders from beyond the wall. We've got to give it a try, and there are many brothers to avenge. I have little hope, but perhaps we can at least recover their bodies.
But we have no hope, sir!
Shut up, buddy.
Listen to me carefully, Worm. Here, everybody fights and nobody runs.
Have pity, sir!
Concentrate on the present, Poddy. If memory serves me, you're not bad with a bow. Cover us from the balcony. Follow me.
At your command.
Let's go.
on me, Westford.
Cover us as long as you can, understood?
I'll do my best.
You'd best do better than that. It's our asses you're covering. We'll go down and stop them from reopening the ancient ice mark. So don't fall asleep.
Damn. They want to open it again. Okay. Yeah, I have better things.
Poddy is a craven wretch, but at least he can aim. Almost open again. I'm certain that other wildlings are waiting on the other side of the wall for Gorn's tribe to open the door. We still haven't seen him, by the way. Be on your guard, Celtigar.
Sir Mors, look behind us. There are more coming.
They came from behind. What's that swine?
Surrounded.
Mors, the gods have given me a feast of crows today.
Gorn, you finally show your face.
This time it's between you and me. Kill the boy.
Oh shit.
Damn you all.
The butcher is mine. Don't interfere. After you die, I'll be a legend. Women will fight for my seed. I'm going to bleed you, old man.
If you knew how many times I've heard that. You're already dead to me, Gorn.
Thank you. Place at the good time. 4 months earlier. 15 years. It's been 15 years since you left River Springs, your family's ancestral lands. As the firstborn son to Lord Reynold Sarwick in the service to the powerful Lannister family, it should have been yours one day. Instead, you fled Westeros, that nest of viper constantly conspiring against each other in their endless game of thrones. You turn your back on the past and cross the narrow sea to live in the free city, far from the webs of intrigue spun by the great families. The religion of Hrolar. Hrolar and its red priests welcome you, and you are not one of them. Although your new fate is not a welcome one in your homeland. However, your past has caught up with you, and after a long voyage, you have returned to the town of your birth, River Spring. Oh.
Finally, we come to River Spring. 15 years ago, it was one of the region's most flourishing towns. But things slowly worsened, and today, River Spring knows only idle craftsmen and discontent among the peasants. And the death of Lord Reynold Sarwick will not improve matters. That said, his death didn't surprise many people. The poor man was but a shadow of his former self since the disappearance of his eldest son. They say that his daughter is the one who makes decisions since then. And you can see where that has led.
River Spring, it is much changed.
Have you been here before?
I used to live in River Spring. I left 15 years ago.
Yes, that was a while ago. Back then, the town was still prosperous.
What happened?
I don't know the details, but I think it had something to do with the eldest Sarwick boy leaving.
I must go to the castle.
Oh? And, if I may ask, what would a red priest like you be doing here?
I am here for the burial ceremony. I am the son of Reynold Sarwick.
How so? You're much too old to be Garwin Sarwick.
Garwin is my young brother. I am the elder, Alistair.
Father above, after so long?
We thought you had disappeared. My sympathies for your father. I did not recognize you.
My god Relor now watches over him. Thank you for the crossing, ferryman.
You're Alistair, the son of a powerful lord of the Westers. Destined for a brilliant future as the lord of Riverspring, you went into exile in the Free Cities after Robert Baratheon's rebellion, taking refuge in the region of Hador, the god of light and love. You are now a red priest at the Temple of Bravos. You have chosen to devote your life to your religion and your god. Contacted by your private tutor, you are now on your way back to your hometown to attend your father's funeral. Your past has caught up with you and you now have to face up with whom you left behind some 15 years ago. Okay. What am I? Oh, one moment, please. Okay, sorry everybody. I had to answer a call. It's a good call. I'm happy. Not sure which one to use. Carcher will be good. No, I like this one actually. Thank you. Oh, dear. Let's go to my father's wake now. Actually, that's good. I was expecting to have the same item as my other guy.
No more travelers, almost no boats. And what is a river? With things as they are, what choice do we have?
If things are so bad, what do you propose to do?
It's been too hard for too long. It's time to revolt. We must take matters into our own hands. We'll take up arms.
You should be careful. If you keep attracting attention this way, the guards will lock you up in the dungeons, or worse.
Perhaps in the time of Lord Reynald, the Curt. But do you see many guards pacing the streets now? The army of Riverspring is but a shadow of what it was. You obviously know nothing of the misery we suffer here.
That may be, but I do know that violence is answered with more violence. This path never ends well.
We're already suffering. What is it to us if we die of hunger or by a sword?
What has happened here? These lands were once thriving.
It's the Lords. It's been too long since they cared about what happens in their own lands. Neighboring lords have taken the chance to grab some of our land, and nothing is done to stop it. And now that Lord Sarwick is dead, it will only get worse. We must do something.
But there are still Sarwicks in Riverspring.
Don't make me laugh. The eldest fled years ago. As for the others, they're no better than he. Anyway, this concerns only the people of Riverspring, stranger.
So be it. I pray that your choices will not lead you to reckless acts. May R'hllor light your path through the shadows.
It is a dying town! Riverspring is dying! You, Aubrey! It's been
weeks. My pigs aren't doing that well either.
Food? Just a coin?
Well, no.
Forgive my boldness, noble stranger, but I cannot let you walk into certain death like that.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm not sure of the customs in the free cities nowadays, but I wouldn't dream of entering Westeros arm like that. And yet, as the smith labors day and night for us, it so happens that I sell the finest weapons. Blunt, cutting, perforating. You know what they say, my lord. Don't buy your blade until you know what you plan to stick it into.
Tell me more about cutting weapons.
The most popular. I know of no weapon passed down through families that is not a sword, my lord, and there are good reasons for that. Cutting weapons are especially designed to fight against light armor such as leather, and even the skin underneath. Do you need more information?
Tell me more about perforating weapons.
An enemy full of holes is considerably less frightening, isn't he? Piercing weapons are especially designed to fight against medium armor, such as chainmail. Do you need more information?
Tell me more.
Ah, the pure blunt weapons are. Do you need more information?
I have things.
Don't hesitate. And don't forget, you'll be wanting armor. After all, no matter the weapon you face.
Okay.
Rumor that our good lord is introducing a new tax.
Piss off, him.
Yeah. Don't have enough money.
Lord, a growth for some food.
Just a rabid hellhound. It's been coming out of both ends for 2 days now. I told him to stop eating wood. The old boar was just too hungry, he wouldn't listen. Game in those woods.
Boards.
Old man, you wouldn't be one of those priests of R'hllor, would you?
Some food? Just a coin? My own eyes. I'm warning you, if he's giving her the box, I'm...
Their children since poor Daffin died.
He finally died, did he? And yeah, he was a tough old sod.
Halt, priest. This town is in mourning. Access to the castle is closed during the ceremony.
I'm actually here to attend Lord Sarwick's burial.
I'm afraid that's not possible. I'm under strict orders to only allow entry to close kin. With the villagers' current grumblings, we don't want to risk problems.
I am Lord Reynald Sarwick's eldest son, and I am here to attend my father's funeral.
His eldest son? Do you take me for a fool? I have been at my post for more than 5 years, and I have never once seen your face.
It has been more than 5 years since I left Riverspring. Please call on Mr. Harwin. He knows of my arrival.
Well, we'll see about that, but I doubt he'll come here for you. The ceremony's about to start. John, go find Maester Harwin.
What is going on here? Why has John gone for the Maester?
Ryman, it's me, Alistair.
Several hells! Alistair? Graydon, I told you only family. That excludes peasants, dogs, and cravens who abandon their families.
Enough, Ryman. However long I was absent, this house is still mine.
How dare you! You disappeared without so much as a goodbye years ago, and now you return as if nothing happened.
The reasons for my exile are mine alone. I owe you no explanation.
I care about your reasons? It's your fault that Lord Sarwick is dead.
You've lost your head, cousin.
Your departure destroyed him. He was never the same again.
Your judgment is clouded, Ryman. I can smell the ale on your breath from here.
What? Stand back! I'll make you eat your words, priest!
Enough! Do you not think we have enough dead here?
Mr. Harwin?
Alistair, finally! I prayed for your return.
This traitor no longer has his place here, Maester Harwin. He abandoned his castle and his family.
Seven gods! Get a hold of yourself, Ryman. I wrote to him to invite him to Lord Sarwick's funeral.
I prefer to leave than to hear more of this.
Alistair, what a relief it is to finally see you. I had help from my contacts in Braavos to inform you of your father's death. The funeral will be in the Godswood. The ceremony has already begun.
Why is it not held at the Sept?
It would be if it were not in ruins. Riverspring is suffering on all fronts, I fear. Let us go now. Come with me, Alistair. Let us speak as we walk.
What happened here, Maester? How could my father allow things to get to this point?
You know, after you left, Lord Reynald changed. He began to live more and more in the past, and stopped taking care of his duties. Your sister quickly found herself managing more than she should have.
Eliana helped my father govern?
Well, these last few months, She's practically run the house herself. In spite of her efforts, she was unable to slow the inevitable ruin of her lands without a lord. But all is not so dark. Many of your father's vassals remain faithful to their oath. They have all come to the burial in order to honor his memory. We will speak of all this again after the ceremony. Let us make haste, I beg of you.
Let's go.
Hello, Red Priest. I am Lady Eliana Sarwick, daughter of the late Lord Sarwick. You are just in time for the ceremony. Were you close to my father?
You have changed much in 15 years, little sister.
Alistair, why have you returned? We don't need you here.
Harwin told me of father's death. It was my duty to come.
15 years without any news. And he had to die for us to see you again. You would have done better to stay where you were.
I do not doubt that my departure was difficult for you.
Difficult? To say the least, your disappearance was our father's ruin. Do you know how long I cried after you left? And how long I hoped for news of you?
I am sorry. I left Westeros without once turning back, it's true. I understand your reaction. It must have been unbearable for you. But I had to leave. Know that I never forgot you.
That's easy for you to say. And you should know that we here learn to live very well without you.
I understand your reaction, Eliana.
I doubt it. Go pay your last respects to Father. We will speak later.
Damn, she's pissed off.
The eternal outcast, now guide you to the Father.
You shall follow his
and
example.
May he judge you fairly and...
Who is that man?
I believe that is the Elder Sarwick, the one who disappeared. He has certainly changed, but I recognize him.
What the fuck? That was unexpected.
How could you desecrate our father's body that way?
I desecrated nothing. I performed the final kiss, the tribute that priests of R'hllor pay to the dead.
You may be a Red Priest, but you should respect the beliefs of Riverspring.
I did not intend to be disrespectful, little sister.
Do not think that it is easy for me to speak with you after all this time.
This is all water under the bridge now.
Yeah,
at the
right.
Time, I saw no other way. 15 years ago, the war that King Robert Baratheon fought to claim the throne forced me to commit deeds which haunt me still. The very idea of returning to you was too painful. I did the only thing left for me to do. I left and began a new life elsewhere. Not long ago, I received a letter from Maester Harwin telling of father's death. I could no longer hide myself. It was time to confront my past. What I regret the most, Eliana, is that by fleeing to the other side of the waters, it is you whom I wounded.
All these years, I have thrown a veil over your memory. And you return at the moment when everything is in turmoil. I must be alone for the moment. I will see you later, Alistair.
Take your time, little sister. I understand.
Alistair, Maester Arwen would like to speak with you. He awaits you in the castle courtyard. And if I may add, you should be ashamed of that kiss during the ceremony.
My thanks, Ravilla. I shall go and see him.
I am not sure there is more to discuss between us, Alistair. I am sincerely sorry for your loss. You know how much your father meant to me. Unless you are truly ready to listen to me, it would be best that you leave.
As you wish.
Alistair, there you are. Please leave us. So, you're not too unsettled by the situation here?
I spoke to Eliana. She has still not accepted my absence.
That's not surprising. She has suffered much since you left. She had toughened against the pain. But now that you are back, she would not know how to react.
I understand her anger. I pray for things to improve with time.
You are not the sole cause of her unhappiness. As I told you, Eliana took over managing the lands when your father began to fade. She moved heaven and earth to try to get Riverspring out of this mire.
Our family has always served House Lannister with loyalty. What have they done to help us?
For 15 years, your father refused to speak with them. But after his death, Ilyana requested an audience with Queen Cersei Lannister. The audience did not go well, and the Queen will only help us once Riverspring has a new lord at its head. So your sister worked towards this end. Riverspring has belonged to House Sarwick for generations. Ilyana has refused to marry a lord from any other house. So, the Queen has chosen a man for your sister.
Who is it?
Valar, your father's bastard son, your half-brother.
Valar? I left Westeros hoping never to hear that name again. It is out of the question for my sister to marry him. He shares our blood. How can the Queen condone a marriage which goes against nature?
You realize that if Ilyana were to wed another lord, she would take her husband's name, being a bastard. Valar has no family name. It was the only solution to keep Riverspring for House Sarwick.
What has changed? He was but a simple squire when he went off to war with me. Only a knight may marry a lady.
Valar rose through the ranks and was knighted. The Queen took him into her service.
But Valar served House Sarwick. How did he get close to the Queen?
Seeing him return alone from the war, your father blamed him for your disappearance. No matter how much Valar claimed to work for the prosperity of House Sarwick, your father wouldn't hear any of it. He cursed him and chased him away from Riverspring for good. Your half-brother was mad with rage and left seeking vengeance. Apparently, he spent several years at the Citadel, using education to compensate for his low birth.
A maester cannot become a lord.
He never became maester, but stopped at the rank of acolyte. He learned the art of war, studied the higher mysteries, and forged links. He was then thrown out of the Citadel several years later for studying the forbidden arts. He's been a sellsword ever since. His reputation spread quickly, and royal ears heard of him. In 2 years, he went from simple soldier to the Queen's guard. He moves in the shadows. The nobles of the court fear him.
How do you know all of this?
I went with your sister to the Red Keep in King's Landing for her audiences with the Queen. It is there that I learned what I know of him.
Valar, he has taken too much from me already. I cannot just stand by while he marries my sister.
There is something else of which we should speak. I would have liked to spare you this. I do not believe that your father's death was an accident. There are certain indications that lead me to believe that he was poisoned.
Are you sure?
Believe me, Alistair, I know this subject. The Strangler is a difficult poison to detect, but it leaves certain traces that cannot be caused by anything else.
Did Father have any ongoing conflicts which could have prompted someone to murder him?
I am not certain, but there are rumors of a possible culprit.
Tell me who it is.
This may overwhelm you, but the rumors say that it is your younger brother, Garwin.
Garwin? He was but a child when I left.
He and Lord Reynold had some serious quarrels, and he disappeared on the very night of your father's death. We've had no news of him since.
Why? Why would he have done such a thing?
Maester Harwin, the people are rebelling. Rioting has broken out throughout the town.
With all of this festering discontent, it was only a matter of time before this happened.
Tell me, does the Riverspring Guard have the situation under control?
For now, they are securing the entrances to the castle. Barricades protect us from a direct attack. But the streets are inaccessible to us. We have too few men. The guard is overwhelmed.
Who is behind this revolt?
I think I know who leads them. I crossed paths with a certain Tyrek when arriving, a rabble-rouser, telling the people to take up arms.
Tyrek? I heard some guards say that he was getting people worked up in the marketplace.
How did things get this far out of hand?
Well, the lords left the castle after the burial, with their fine clothes and all. Whereas the villagers are starving, all of this flaunted wealth must have pushed them too far. Everything erupted. The villagers began to attack the lords, taking them hostage.
You said that the revolt is being led from the main square. We must go there immediately.
Captain Ryman says that it's impossible. Our men are barely managing to keep them at bay at the castle doors. There are not enough of us to attempt an escape.
Where is Captain Ryman?
He is at the doors. He's the one that ordered the barricades.
Seven hells! If Ryman deals with it, the revolt will end in flames and bloodshed.
Riverspring has already suffered too much. I must join Ryman. Riverspring needs me. I will not watch our land fall into ruins without acting.
Very well. But I beg you to be careful. You are a Sarwick. Act as a liege, Lord Alster. And know that your acts will have consequences.
I will do what must be done.
I am sure you will.
Let's do this.
Well, well, look who's here. Dear Alistair, what have you come for, my good cousin?
I hope you're thinking more clearly than you were earlier.
I have no lessons to learn from a coward.
Let's not start that again. Ryman, I did not come here to fight with you. What can you tell me of the situation here?
We've almost regained control of the southern part of town. My soldiers are about to clean it out. But in the marketplace, there are still skirmishes between rioters and people loyal to our cause. Nobles who came for the ceremony are still being held hostage by rebels on the docks in the northern part of town.
Very well. Let's go, Ryman. I want to see this for myself.
Really? His lordship would like to see this for himself? Well, then, I'd be happy to accompany you to see this. I cannot wait to see you reason with this gang of peasants. I hope that blade at your belt is not just for decoration. Here, take my flask. You might need it.
this damn gate!
We'll set everything on fire!
We'll die of hunger! Have the gate opened, or we'll set fire to your cursed castle!
Calm down. There is no point in going to such extremes. I am aware that things are not going well here, but burning down the castle won't make things any better.
So, what do you suggest? We are starving!
As the son of the late Lord Sarwick, I will ensure that the castle's food reserves are distributed as soon as order has been returned.
The Sarwick's personal supplies? That just might do. Come along, men! Let's go home!
Open this gate. I'm going to town.
Understood.
Clive! Bloody Lugor!
Many men of the Watch are dying today.
There are so many people, and they are so well organized. Too organized for a simple rebellion. Open the gate. I'm returning to the castle.
Very well.
Open.
Understood.
I'm sorry, my lord. Tyrek asks us to keep them here for as long as possible. Do not kill us. We beg of you.
You chose sides by participating in all of this. It is time to take responsibility for your actions.
We'll join the others when we're ready.
Keep away. We're just returning the favor.
Psst. My God, are those my men? What are you doing here?
Captain, there are rebels everywhere. We had to hide here to get away from them. With only crossbows, we wouldn't have lasted long against a horde of peasants armed with pitchforks.
Are you men of the guard or not?
But it's an enormous crowd, armed to the teeth in the marketplace.
We will attempt to resolve the situation, but I will need your help. Go and position yourselves high on the roofs and balconies with a clear view of the square.
At your command, my lord.
Crossbowmen up high? I quite like that idea. It will lend weight to our argument.
They will not fire, Ryman. Our sole objective is to make the villagers see reason.
I doubt it will work.
You are completely mad. Nothing good will come of this revolt.
You'd better think well, Baker. If you're not with us, you're against us.
Please, Preston, just listen to yourself. We've lived in the same town since we were little.
What's going on here? Attacking the castle guards wasn't enough for you. You have to fight amongst yourselves, too.
Ah, there are the guards. Milords, we are faithful to House Sarwick, and we're trying to calm them, but it's impossible to make them listen to reason.
Traitors! You wish to continue living in squalor and eating only what the lords shit out?
Silence! I am the son of the late Lord Sarwick. Who is behind this revolt?
He's a merchant who works at the port, goes by the name of Tyrek. He's well respected by the people of Riverspring.
At least he's one of ours. He suffers with us and fights with us. He's the only one who's dared to act while we die in squalor.
I understand. I will ask that food from the castle be distributed, but first you must stop this revolt.
You would do that? Swear by the Seven, and we will put down our weapons.
The Seven are not my gods. I swear to keep my word by the divine light of R'hllor.
I know nothing of your god, but I trust your word.
The people will never be abandoned again. Trust me.
My thanks, my lord. I was so afraid the situation would get out of hand.
Unfortunately, Riverspring has seen too much of its own blood these last hours.
Tyrek promised them that there would be no innocent victims, and those poor sods believed him.
Giving out the castle's food like that, the villagers will be thankful for it, but it won't last for long.
Shit! The captain of the guard! Not a step further, or we will kill all of these lords!
Bastards! They're going after the burial guests! How do you want to proceed, Alistair?
I am Alistair Sarwick. Release her immediately. I will not tolerate you attacking people with impunity.
Never! We've got nothing to lose! It's this, or starve to death!
Ryman, let's show them how justice is done in Riverspring.
You leave us with no choice. Kill her, cutthroat!
You should never have done that.
Let's go. Rosamund! Those vermin killed Rosamund!
The Lord of Light's flames will embrace her.
How dare you speak such words! Your worthless beliefs have no place here.
I am sorry if my words have offended you.
It will take more than apologies to wash away such blasphemy.
Damn.
Poor woman. She didn't deserve that.
What were you doing, ferryman?
The lords wanted me to help them leave the town, but these brutes attacked us before I could cast off the moorings. It's a good thing you arrived when you did. I didn't think I'd make it. Let me know if I can return the favor one day.
The fools thought they could stop us. They don't know us very well.
What are you doing? This is no time to stand about. The town is rife with fire and bloodshed.
I know it better than most, my lord. I lost my three sons today. There's nothing to keep me here any longer.
I understand your pain, but suicide is not the solution. Keep hold of your life and R'hllor's benevolence will soothe your soul.
R'hllor? What do you mean?
R'hllor is the warmth in your home, the comfort of a mother's breast, and the sweetness of a woman's words. Go to him, and the path will seem less dark.
Yeah, follow the way of Fador.
Do not stay here if you don't wish to end up like him.
Clever now that he's hanging there like a...
Stop! Leave that man be!
We're just taking back what is ours. These cursed lords have made our life hard for far too long.
Perhaps you want us to slit your throats, like the vultures you are.
It's been too long since you received just rewards for your labor, but things will change. Our town will soon be filled with the light of R'hllor.
R'hllor? What are you going on about?
Go home, and thank the Lord of Light for sparing your lives today. Open the gate.
Very well.
Ah, there you are, Captain. We were about to execute these men. They must learn who's in charge here.
These people must have committed serious crimes if they are to be executed.
They were amongst the rioters. They must be guilty of something.
If you execute people without reason, the situation will only grow worse. Allow me some time.
What shall we do, Captain?
These vermin don't deserve such kind treatment. But fine. Let's see what my cousin is made of.
Tell us why you're here, friend.
They started it. We just came to ask for something to eat.
Shut your mouth, scum. You killed one of our men in the port, and you will pay for that.
This guard claims to have seen you at the port storehouse.
I was there with the others to demand food, my lord. But I'd already left when that guard got an axe through the head.
Let him go.
Very well.
This man was found near the dying body of one of our men. Look at him. He's pissed himself. You don't need more proof than that.
What were you doing near this guard's body?
I beg of you, my lord. I am innocent. I swear it by the Seven.
That is not what I asked. Why were you close to the body?
I am innocent. I did nothing. I killed no one.
You may execute him.
Yes, my lord. You're finally to die, you piece of shit.
I've nothing to do with all this. My lot kept out of it from the start.
I don't give a damn. You've been a pain in our asses for far too long.
What were you doing during the rioting?
I live in the inn overlooking the port with some friends. We haven't set foot outside since the revolt started. A group of armed guards arrived and dragged me off in the middle of a game of cards. So, that is River Spring justice, huh? Quick executions without reason?
This man has nothing to do with the current troubles. We are not going to start killing the people of River Spring without reason.
Next time you won't be so lucky, scum.
Thank you, my lord.
You'll pay for what you did, whore.
I wish you had been in your squalid house as it burned.
If you set his house on fire, you do realize that a lord can cut off your hands for far less than that.
Please, don't cut off my hands, my lord. Your guard there, he took advantage of the rioting to violate my little sister. I found her in tears, unable to speak.
You can't call that rape. The girl didn't even put up a fight.
I'll gut you and make you eat your own shit.
Your behavior is the cause of all this. You are the only person here who deserves punishment. Send him to the dungeons while I decide his fate, and let this woman go.
I cannot thank you enough, my lord.
Are you done, my lord?
Yes, but no one is to take such decisions in the future without telling me first. Try to at least hear what they have to say before passing sentence. Is that understood?
Yes, my lord.
My lord Sarwick, Tyrick, the leader of the revolt, has turned up at the castle doors. He will only negotiate with you.
The traitor finally shows his face. It's time to put a stop to this madness.
If the people followed him, then this man earned their respect. He deserves to be listened to. Guard, tell him I'm on my way.
Very well, my lord.
At last! The man who everyone is talking about? The famous Alistair Sarwick? We already spoke in the quay. You pretended you were just a foreigner, but now that you're with your guards, you finally show your true face.
This morning I was only a stranger, but the situation has changed and I have to act. You are the man who started the rioting which led to a full revolt.
You know nothing of our problems! Your family sits warm in your castle while we die of hunger in the streets.
He proved that he is on our side today, Tyrek.
I've made decisions which may seem unjust to you, but they were for the good of Riverspring. Our town is where it is today because ties with the lords of the Westerlands have been cut. To bring our lands back to health, we must gain the trust and support of the lords.
Unfortunately, your efforts seem to be in vain, Alistair.
May the lords of the Westerlands rest easy. From now on, I will do everything in my power to restore Riverspring to its former glory.
You disgust me. You reveal yourself for what you are. Despite your actions during the rioting, you defend the privileges of the lords. Nothing changes. The people will continue to die of hunger while the lords feast.
During the rioting, the people of Riverspring did not die of hunger. They died by the sword, Tyrek. Do you not take any blame for having brought about these massacres? Riverspring has suffered heavy losses on both sides, the people and the guards alike.
The guard will fight to the end for the survival of Riverspring, but your decisions did not help us at all. You're so interested in gaining the people's love that you'll lead the town to ruin. You can't rule the town with weak actions.
The people no longer support you, Tyrek. Your cause means nothing now.
He's right, Tyrek. The rioting was foolery. Many of our people died today. Leave it be.
Enough bloodshed, Tyrek. Accept your defeat. Accept your situation. You have no support anymore.
You may have calmed them with your pretty speeches, but I know that it won't change and we'll just keep dying.
I will rebuild Riverspring again if it costs me my life. And you will hear it all from the dungeons. Guards, take him away.
You succeeded, Lord Alistair. These riots very nearly destroyed Riverspring.
Harwin, you address me as Lord now?
Although you do not officially hold the title of Lord, you have shown that you have the soul of one. From this point forth, I shall address you as such.
I shall try to be worthy of your trust. The town may be appeased, but I could not please everyone.
It is difficult to lead. Your choices will always leave someone unhappy. The important thing is that you made decisions where others would simply let the situation deteriorate. The decisions you made today brought peace back to Riverspring. That is all that matters.
He is right, Alistair. I never thought I would say this, but Riverspring needs a man like you. It would be a shame for you to leave now.
Thank you, Ryman. Rest assured, I do not intend to leave. Not anymore.
Good to hear.
Now that this matter has been taken care of, I would like to carry on our discussion regarding my brother, Garwin.
Not here, Alistair. It has been a particularly delicate matter since the death of Lord Reynold. Find me at the castle.
Understood.
Okay.
Alistair, it is important that I speak with you.
What is it, little sister?
I am sorry for the cold welcome during the burial. I lied to myself by saying that you no longer meant anything to me. When Harwin informed me that you were helping Ryman handle the rioting, I was afraid something would happen to you. I would never have forgiven myself.
Do not worry, little sister. I have returned.
Are you planning to remain at Riverspring?
I will restore Riverspring to its former glory.
How do you intend to do that?
I have decided to seek an audience with the Queen at the Red Keep in order to reclaim my titles and inheritance.
You do not have to do that, Alistair. You know, I have reached an agreement with the Queen. If I wed Valar, the Crown will once again recognize the sovereignty of a lord at Riverspring and will agree to help us.
Yes, Harwin spoke of it to me, and it only reinforces my determination.
Don't be a fool, Alistair. If the Queen were to take insult from your approach, we could lose everything.
I know that, but this marriage would mean the end of Riverspring. You do not know the true nature of Valar.
I am well aware of that vulture's reputation. He and I have nothing in common, but unfortunately he is close to the Queen. House Lannister is the richest house in Westeros, and one of the most powerful. With a faithful vassal such as Valar, they will surely help us.
I see your point of view, sister, but I will not allow Valar to share a future with House Sarwyck. I spoke to Harwin, and he told me that Father had banished him, and rightly so. I would not have you make such a sacrifice to keep Riverspring in the family.
I'm sorry, but I cannot share your optimism, brother. I hope your words will move the Queen. I bid you take leave and speak with Harwin now.
Let's speak now that we are alone, Harwin. Tell me of Garwin. I remember little of him as a child. He was restless, but not bad at heart.
He has certainly grown up since then. His relationship with your father had become increasingly strained these past few years.
To what extent?
Well, their arguments had become increasingly violent. Several days before his death, your father disinherited Garwin. As a son of a noble family, to be disinherited is a fate worse than death. This could be reason enough for Garwin to commit the unforgivable.
But there is no solid evidence of that, is there?
No, just theory. However, since this happened, Garwin has disappeared.
Would you know where he might have gone?
He enjoyed visiting your men, sir, in King's Landing.
I happen to be going there to seek an audience with the Queen. I will see if I can find him. My priority is to get my titles back. I will become the lord of these lands as my father wished. I will find a way to stop the marriage. Valar will not have Riverspring.
The Seven be praised. It is a relief to hear it.
But before all else, I must inform the priesthood of my decision.
Your old bedchamber is still there. Lord Reynold did not want it touched. I ask that it be readied in the hope of your arrival.
I thank you, Harwin. Good evening, Master Betharios.
What news from your stay on the other continent?
The news is quite dark, I'm afraid. I pray that R'hllor will light my path. My family and my house have not fared well. I cannot return to Braavos. I must take my rightful place here.
The night is dark and full of horrors, my brother. I understand that you may not leave your people to wander blindly, far from the light of R'hllor. But in making this choice, Does it mean that you have decided to leave our order?
I did not say that. I am and will remain devoted to R'hllor until I die. The fact that I remain in Westeros in no way changes my dedication to our temple. Quite the contrary.
What do you mean?
I believe that our organization would do well to have a Lord of Westeros devoted to our cause. The light of R'hllor will shine upon my subjects and neighbors.
I see. Well, we can only encourage such initiative. Our order has little representation on the continent of Westeros.
I may need you to send me Denyo to help me in this task.
It will be done. No more than the two of you. I will inform the rest of the clergy of your decision and your devotion, Master Alistair. May the light watch over you.
I thank you, Master Betharios. May the light watch over you as well.
Riverspring has recognized his authority, and it would seem that he has decided to stay for good.
Indeed. I spoke to him about it, and he has decided to take on his responsibilities here.
Maester Harwin, do you truly believe that he has a chance of changing the Queen's mind?
Have confidence in your brother, Ilyana.
I don't doubt my brother. I doubt Valar.
Worry not, little sister. Harwin, prepare for my voyage. I'm leaving for King's Landing in order to request an audience with the Queen. R'hllor, as my witness, I will be the new master of Riverspring.
Chapter 3, Moors, on the present day. Your incredible wrist elves starve off the menace of a wildling invasion. This is a great victory for the Night's Watch. You rid the gift of one of the wildling most dangerous leaders, although the loss of a patrol was a heavy price to pay. Moreover, you were nearly killed yourself, alone against an entire clan. Your fate should have been sealed. You owed your survival to the well-timed arrival of your brothers, who defeated the Riders. The Raiders. That was the last thing you saw before you lost consciousness. So? What's going on?
Morse! Morse! By the gods, Morse. Only you would take on so many wildlings on your own. I was afraid we'd arrive too late.
Indeed. But at what price? My men are dead, as well as those from Cragan's patrol.
In spite of our losses, it is a good day for the Night's Watch. Gorn and his curs would have bled our ranks for years to come.
Despite all that, I owe my life to you and your men.
My honor for the wall. My life for my brothers.
Corrin, there was another ranger with me. A little thief from Fleabottom. I stationed him up there with his bow. Did you see him?
Neither him nor his body. You're the only survivor we found.
I see. I'll try to find out what happened to him. I must find him before reporting to Lord Commander Mormont.
The Night's Watch lacks the strength it once had. The wildling should never have been able to travel this far in the gift.
Take nothing for granted. Nothing lasts forever. We know that better than anyone.
I'll have my men sweep the area until our builders arrive to block up the opening. We'll take care of the slain. Good luck finding the boy, brother.
My thanks. I am greatly indebted to you, Corrin.
Okay, so let's end the stream here for the moment. So thank you for watching, everybody, and see you next time. Bye.